Money, or you can call and just receive Jesus if that's what you really wanted. So she called and she prayed and she received Jesus as her Lord and Savior. But we all know that Satan is going to come back behind her and test her. At 10 years old, her 3-year-old cousin, who was like a brother to her, was beaten to death by her stepfather. She said that she didn't understand how God could do this. She thought that God would love and protect people, so she became an atheist and she hated God. She hated Christians, she talked bad, she put Christians on blast, made fun of them in front of everybody and stuff like that. And then she, by the age 16, she decided, I'm going to commit suicide. So she decided that day, I'm going to go and I'm going to commit suicide. But God had a different plan for her life. And it just blessed me because her grandmother was nagging her, come to church, come to church, come to church, come to church. Now, this is a person who you wouldn't expect to come to church because she hates God and Christians. Well, to get her grandma to stop yelling at her, she said, okay, I'll come. So she sat in the back, and the preacher was talking about how, about families and dysfunction. And he said that, these kids grow up with so much pain, and we belittle them and act like, oh, you'll know what it's like when you get older. He said, but you don't know what they go through, and you don't know the pain and weight that they carry. And that was her. And when she heard that, she said that every time that he said pain, her heart began to break more, and God began to do something in her. So the pastor stopped and started to cry, and he said, there's a suicidal spirit in here. I want you to come forward so I can pray with you. And she was all weird. She said that she kept feeling weird because she didn't want to go up in front of everybody. She knew God was calling her, but she didn't want to because the same people that she blasted was inside the church at that point in time. So she started to go towards the door, and the deacon stopped, and he was crying. And he said to her, God wants me to speak to you. He wants you to know that even though you've never known an earthly father, I will be a better father to you. He loves you, and he wants to take your pain away to heal the pain in your heart. God wants you to know he sees you crying yourself to sleep every night, and he didn't intend for you to live like that way. He came so that you would have life and have it to the fullest. And that day, she went home, and she started her journey with God again. Amen. So listen to the words, because she's talking about how that whole day was, all she could feel was God around her all day long. So this is basically what the song is about that day.